First one, the first electric train of India, Deccan Queen, was run between. So this session is going to be mostly about the unique features, right? The first one, option A, Aura and Delhi. Option A, Aura and Delhi. Option B, Kalyan and Pune. Option C, Bombay and Surat. Option D, New Delhi and Madras. And option none of these. So the first electric train in India was run between Kalyan and Pune. So earlier it was called Kalyan, C-A-L-Y-N. Now it's called as K-L-Y-N, Kalyan and Pune. So Kalyan is very, very close to Bombay. So Kalyan, Bombay region we call it. So between Kalyan and Pune, it was the first electric train that was run. Which of the most widely circulated daily newspaper in India? See, out of the options given here, every time we have to concern with the options given in the paper. Now, out of the options given here, the Times of India is the highest circulated daily newspaper in the country. Out of these options which are given here. And this keeps on changing from year to year, so you have to keep a check on every year's list. The first Indian university opened in AD 57 was, remember that, in 1857, the first Indian university is nothing but Kolkata University. So, this is the first Indian university opened. In 1857, there is nothing but Kolkata University. Which of the following monuments is the oldest? Option A, Khajuraho, paintings famous. Option B, Ajanta Caves. Option C, Taj Mahal. Option D, Qutub Minar. Option E, none of these. Remember that Ajanta Caves are the oldest one. They date back to BC. So, the oldest monuments in the country is nothing but Ajanta Caves. You should know that Ajanta and Ellora are the caves present in Maharashtra near Aurangabad region. So, these are the very, very important archaeological sites in the country, Ajanta Caves. India's first satellite launching station is located in, that's very, very famous. Okay. So, option A is Chennai, option B is Ahmedabad, option C is Tumba, option D is Srikakulam, option E is nothing but none of these. Now, you should also know that near Thiruvananthapuram, we have got something called as the Tumba station, Tumba launch station. So, this is a very, very famous and it is the first satellite launching stations present in the country. So, the answer is nothing but Tumba. The first railway line in India was started in the year. Options 1828, 1835, 1853, 1883 and 1843. So, Bombay to Thane is the first railway line in India. It started in the year 1853. So, there is the first railway line in the country, Bombay to Thane. The largest and the oldest museum of India is located in the State Union Territory. Remember that the oldest and the largest museum is nothing but Imperial Museum. And where is the present? Is it AP or UP or West Bengal or New Delhi or Assam? And the right answer would be West Bengal. West Bengal has got the Imperial Museum, which is the oldest and the largest in the country. Very important. And once you go to West Bengal, Kolkata, you should be able to see that. The first financial service park for industry is being set up in. See, answers are Pune, Surat, Gurgaon, Bangalore and Kolkata. I know you know that Bangalore is the high tier of the country. Now, when you come to this financial service park, it has been established in the city of Gurgaon. It is also called as Gurugram. It is also called as what? Gurugram or Gurgaon. Remember that Gurugram is also famous for having something called as ISA, International Solar Alliance. And very, very recently, International Solar Alliance is also is in news for India and France being elected as the president and co-president. Okay. And we got re-elected as president and co-president. That's how it's very, very important. International Solar Alliance is the first international organization started by India. So, that's why it's very, very important. Next one. The first field marshal of India was, remember that field marshal is one of the highest positions in the army. Okay. Now, this position is being removed, but if you see out of this A. Vaidya, K. M. Kariyappa, Sundarji, S.F.J. Manekshaw, none of these, the answer is nothing but S.F.J. Manekshaw. He is the first field marshal, now we don't have this position. Okay. And K. M. Kariyappa, some people doubt, but K. M. Kariyappa is the first commander-in-chief of army, commander-in-chief of army, who is that? K.M. Kariyappa. And the day K.M. Kariyappa took charge as the first commander-in-chief of army, we are celebrating as Army Day. Okay. And SFJ Manekshaw is the first field marshal in the country. So now this position no more exists. India's first lady special suburban train was started by which of the following zones of Indian Railways? So, first lady suburban train was started by Western Railways, Mumbai. So, Western Railways is the first railways zone which has started this first suburban train for the lady special. Okay, very, very important Western Railways. See, from examination point of view, you should know the headquarters of each and every railways. South Central Railways, Southern Railways, East Coast Railways, okay, Eastern Railways. So, all railways, Central Railways, where is the headquarters of each railways, that is also important. Who was the first Indian to go into space? First Indian to go into space. Option A, Satish Dhawan. Option B, Ravi Malhotra. Option C, Rakesh Sharma. Option D, none of this. Option E, Anil Tagore. And in one of the earlier session already made a point, okay. First person to get into space is Yuri Gagarin, and the first Indian to get into space is nothing but Rakesh Sharma. What is that? Rakesh Sharma is the first person to get into space. Okay, very, very, very important. The first multi-purpose project of India is, okay, see, very, very important question. Option A, Damodar Valley project. Option B, Rihand project. Option C, Bakranagar project. Option D, Hirakud Dam. Option D is none of this. What is the question? First multi-purpose project of India. First multi-purpose project of India. Now, when you look into this, multi-purpose means the project which is designed to control the flood, to supply irrigation water, to supply drinking water, to produce electricity. So, for this multi-purpose, the project is being constructed. And in India, the first multi-purpose project in the country is nothing but Damodar Valley project, DVC, Damodar Valley Corporation. Very, very important. And remember that Damodar Valley is called as a RUR of India. What is it called as? A RUR of India, Damodar Valley Corporation. And one more important aspect is nothing but when you come to the first with respect to the project is concerned, remember first or unique aspects if you take into consideration. Highest dam in the country is nothing but Theri Dam on river Bhagirathi. Longest dam is nothing but Hirakud Dam. First hydroelectricity project is nothing but Shivana Samudram HEP. Like this, when you come to these dams, these first things are very, very important to make a note of. And highest gravity dam in the country is nothing but Sardar Sarovar Dam. So, all these are unique aspects. The first underground railway in India was opened in 1984 Underground Railway, 1984. So, not that old, bit recent only. You know that Kolkata is the one to start the first underground railway line. So, the answer would be obviously Kolkata. And even when you come to metro also, first metro is in Kolkata only. And in Kolkata, metro is underground. Where you see other things, Delhi or you go to Hyderabad, Bangalore, they are above the ground. So, like this, Kolkata takes this first position. So, till now, whatever you see, museum, okay, and many of the things are first in Kolkata only. Okay. Next one. Who among the following was the first woman Chief Justice of High Court? So, women empowerment, Drushta Betkunde is important question. This important question for women empowerment is concerned. So, we have got options as option A, Geeta Mukherjee, option B, Leela Seth. Option C, Sujata Manohar. Option D, Rani Jethmalani. Option E, none of this. Now, your answer is nothing but Leela Seth. Leela Seth became the Chief Justice of Delhi High Court. By becoming the Chief Justice of Delhi High Court, she took this honor of being the first female High Court Chief Justice, Leela Seth. So, the answer is nothing but B. Which is the oldest theatre in India? You know theatres, right? Oldest theatre in the country. Option A, New Theatre Kolkata. Option B, Gaiti Theatre Shimla. Option C, Rabindra Theatre Delhi. Option D, Prithvi Theatre Mumbai. Option E, Madan Theatre Kolkata. Remember that the first theatre in India was started by Jamshedji Madan. So obviously that answer is nothing but Madan Theatre in Kolkata. So this is the first theatre in the country. When was the first air conditioned train introduced in India? So first train with air condition. Okay, very important. Okay, so train journeys in India now becoming air conditioned is very, very important. The first air conditioned train in India started in the year 1969. So this is the first air conditioned train that was introduced in India. Okay, nowadays as the global warming is happening, AC stuffs are becoming very, very important. See, a very important question, this one. Very, very important question, very confusing question also. The first Governor General of India after independence was? See the question properly. Governor General of India after India attained independence. Means in 1947, India got independence. Then who was the Governor General of India after 1947? Now, after this, we know that Dr. Rajendra Prasad is the first President of India and Jawaharlal Nehru is the first Prime Minister of India. Now, the options are two options. One is A, C, Rajgopalachari, C, Lord Mountbatten. Now, if you see, C, Rajgopalachari is the first Indian Governor General of Independent India, first Indian Governor General. But when you come to Lord Mountbatten, he is the first Governor General of Independent India. So, in 1947, when India became independent, India and Pakistan got separated. India asked Lord Mountbatten to continue as the Governor General of India, whereas Pakistan got their father of the nation as the Governor General of India. But India has asked Lord Mountbatten to continue. After Lord Mountbatten, then for the first time Indian took charge, there is nothing but C. Rajgopalachari. So here the answer is nothing but Lord Mountbatten, because they did not mention first Indian Governor General, they just mentioned first Governor General of India, independent India. So if they ask you Indian, then the answer would be Rajgopalachari. Otherwise the answer is nothing but Lord Mountbatten. Who was the first lady governor of Indian state? First lady governor of Indian state. Means you take any state in the country, first lady governor. Option A, Padmaja Naidu. Option B, Sarojini Naidu. Option C, Sucheta Kripalani. Option D, Mrs. Tarakeshwari Sinha. Option E, none of these. Now, here two people we need to concentrate. This one and this one. First one, Sarojini Naidu. You know that Sarojini Naidu is called as the Nightingale of India. And remember that Sarojini Naidu is the first women governor in the country for the central province. For central province, she acted as the first woman governor of the country. So the answer is definitely Sarojini Naidu. Then what about Sucheta Kripalani? She is the first chief minister in the country. Sucheta Kripalani is the first chief minister in the country. So that is how these two people are very, very important personalities. Which among the following ranks in Indian Air Force is the highest? So you take Indian Air Force, we have got Indian Navy, Indian Army, Indian Air Force. Now, out of these, when you come to Indian Air Force, what is the highest position one can attain? Option A, Flying Officer. Option B, Air Commander. Option C, Wing Commander. Option D, Squadron Leader. Option E, Air Marshal. Remember that for Air Force, it will be Air Marshal as the highest position. Okay. Like you have got Army General, like you have got Air Marshal in the Air Force. So, all these people will be reporting to the CDS. So, like this, this is the highest position in the Air Force. And remember that Indian Air Force started in the year 1932. And one more important point. When you come to this Army, Navy and everything, remember that January 15th, Army Day. October 8th. Air Force Day, and December 4th, Navy Day. These are the three important days that you should be remembering. January 15th, Army Day. October 8th, Air Force Day. December 4th, Navy Day. So these three important days are there, which are very, very important for us. Who among the following was the first defense minister of India? See here. Option A, K.M. Karyappa, definitely not. Sardar Patel, definitely home minister. Maulana Azad, he is also not a defense minister. He was the first education minister in the country, Maulana Azad. His birthday is celebrated as a National Education Day also. And here we got two things. One is N. Gopalaswamy Iyengar and Baldev Singh Chokkar. Remember that from 1947 to 1952, it was Baldev Singh Chokkar who was the first defense minister of the country. From 1952 onwards, then it was N. Gopalaswamy Iyengar. Means after the elections took place in the country, then Gopalaswamy Iyengar. But before elections, from the time we got independence, it was Baldev Singh Chokkar who was the first defense minister of the country. So very, very, very important. The first person to consider heart transplantation in India is, who is the first person to be considered for a heart transplantation in India? So option A, Dr. P.K.K. Iyengar. Option B, Dr. R. Valiathan. Option C, Dr. P. Venugopal. Option D, Dr. R. Kesavan Nair. Option E, none of these. Now, remember that for a doctor from All India Institute of Medical Sciences, Dr. P. Venugopal is the first surgeon to conduct a heart transplantation. So, this is important for being a first in the heart transplantation in India. And most of the people who are succumbing to death in India is because of the heart diseases. So, the heart diseases impact was fifth in the country earlier, but now it has taken the top position. So, very, very important, Dr. P. Venugopal. Next question. Who among the following was the first chief of air staff? First chief of air staff. I told you that, don't misunderstand that it should be an Indian. Why? Because I already told you, Indian Air Force started in the year 1932 as an auxiliary air force for British Air Force. Means as a helping air force for the British. So, when it started, the first chief of air staff, so option is the Sir Ronald Lovell Chapman, H. Mulgaonkar, Sir Thomas Elmhurst, Sir Gerald Gibbs, and none of this. Here the answer is nothing but Sir Thomas Elmhurst. He is the first chief of air staff. So, he is actually a foreigner. The oldest Hindu epic is here. Clearly, out of all the four options, Ramayana, Mahabharata, Mahabhasya, Akshadhyay, so don't consider this. Now, out of these four options, we will be doubtful of two things. One is Ramayana or Mahabharata. Now, remember that when you look into Mahabharata, there will be a mention of Lord Rama in Mahabharata. Okay, Krishna mentions that. But when you look into Ramayana, there will not be any mention of Mahabharata. Means clearly visible that Ramayana is the oldest Hindu epic in the country. What is that? Ramayana. Largest can be Mahabharata, but the oldest one is definitely Ramayana. So, very, very important. The answer is nothing but option A, Ramayana. Next one. The first bus service from Delhi to Lahore was started in. So, you know that when Atal Bihari Vajpayee was the Prime Minister, Nawaz Sharif was the Prime Minister of Pakistan then. What happened? They started a bus service. So, the options are option A, February 1999, option B, February 2000, option C, March 1999, option D, March 2000, or April 1999. Out of all these things, remember that the answer is in February. In the month of February, we started a Lahore and Delhi bus service. It was meant to improve the ties with India and Pakistan. But after a few days, again there was a problem and again we are back to normal things. So, basically the fundamental issues has to be addressed before we start up all these aspects. That is very important. So, this is with respect to February 1999 Delhi Lahore bus service. India's first successful surface-to-surface missile is what? So, option A, Agni, option B, Prithvi, option C, Akash, option D, Vayu, and none of this. Obviously, the question says surface-to-surface, it should be related to Earth. So, since it should be related to Earth, the answer is nothing but Prithvi. So, the right answer is nothing but Prithvi is the first successful surface-to-surface air missile. The first electric railway line was opened in. When was the first electric railway line opened? Option A, 1853. Option D, 1885. Option C, 1905. Option D, 1925. And option C is nothing but 1915. The question is, the first electric railway line was opened in. They are not asking about India or the world. And remember, it happened in UK, it happened in the year 1925. So, 1925 is the year for which the first electric line was opened. So,
the transportation of the train was through electricity. That's very, very important. The first president of USA to visit India was, it has become very, very recent, like Donald Trump also visited India. Like this, who was the first president among all these presidents who visited India? Remember that first one is A. Thomas Jefferson, B. John F. Kennedy, very famous president of Pakistan, of USA, and D.W. Eisenhower, and George Washington, and none of these. If we see that, out of them, who is the first person to visit, first president of USA to visit India, the answer is D.W. Eisenhower. Remember that during that point of time, Jawaharlal Nehru was the Prime Minister of India. So when Jawaharlal Nehru was the Prime Minister of India, this person has visited India and is the first one. And in the history of USA, John F. Kennedy, very, very important. It is because of John F. Kennedy, okay, one important day also has evolved with respect to the consumer rights. Okay, John F. Kennedy wrote a letter to the US Congress to frame laws and regulations on the consumer rights. That is how we are celebrating World Consumer Rights Day also on March 15th. So it is because of John F. Kennedy. So very, very important president of USA. The first Indian woman to scale Mount Everest was. So what are the options that we have? Aarti Saha, Asha Agarwal, Bachendri Pal, Rita Ferry, none of these. Remember that. out of all these people, one lady, she is also recipient of Padma Bhushan. And she is none other than Bachendri Pal. So she is the first woman to scale Mount Everest. And Mount Everest is the highest peak in the world with almost 8,848 meters. So highest peak in the world is nothing but Mount Everest. When you come to India, K2 or Godwin Asri is the highest, but that is a part of occupied Kashmir. When you come to the current region controlled by India, then Kanchenjunga is the highest. So these are very, very important things to be make a note of. The first Indian American woman to go into space was. Okay. Option A, Harbhas Kaur. Option B, Bachendri Pal. Option C, Sucheta Kripalani. Option D, Kalpana Chawla. None of these. Remember that one lady who had actually took Indian name across the world is none other than Kalpana Chawla. It's Kalpana actually. Remember that Kalpana Chawla went into the space, but she expired when she was on the back journey. When she was ridden back, then things went out of control and nothing was left over. So like this, Kalpana Chawla had took a great place in the history of Indian astronomy. Very, very important. Which of the following is the first university in India to be run in the private sector? Jawaharlal Nehru University of Life Sciences, Sonia Gandhi National University of Oceanography, Indira Gandhi University of Environmental Sciences, Rajiv Gandhi National University of Computer, and Sikkim Manipal University. Now question is what, first it should be a private university, it should be the first university, oldest private university. So obviously the answer is nothing but Sikkim Manipal University. Sikkim Manipal University is the oldest private university in the country. So answer is nothing but option E, Sikkim Manipal University. Who started the first newspaper in India? Dadabhai Nauroji, Sir Syed Ahmed Khan, Rabindranath Tagore, James A. Hickory, and none of these. Remember that James A. Hickory is one person who started a newspaper called Bengal Gazette. He started a newspaper called as a Bengal Gazette. So this is the first newspaper in India. What is that? Bengal Gazette. Very, 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 very important. Very, very important. The deepest port of the countries. So this is a question related to the seaports. When you take India's peninsular part of the country, you got almost on the complete, if you see the coastline, 7,517 kilometers is the coastline of India. Okay, almost 5,700 comes into the mainland of India. Okay, now on this mainland, total if you see, you have 13 ports. Out of these, 12 ports are present on the mainland. What are they? You got Kandla port in Gujarat, you got Mumbai port and JNPT port in Maharashtra, two ports. You got one port in Goa, Marmagoa. You got one port in Karnataka, New Mangalore port. You got one port in Kerala, Cochin port. You got three major ports in Tamil Nadu, Ennur port, Chennai port, okay,
Let us say you got one more port present in Tamil Nadu also. One more port would be, one is Ennur or Madurai Kamaraj port. One more port is Chennai port. And you got one more important port present in Tamil Nadu. I'm not getting the name. And you got one more port in Andhra Pradesh. There is nothing but Vizag port. And we have got one port in Odisha. That's called Paradeep. And you got one more port in West Bengal. That's called as the Banga. In Banga Coast, you have got something called as the Haldia port. Out of all this, if you see, remember that for India, the what is the continental slope, or you can say continental shelf, is more for a western coast. But when you come to the eastern coast, the continental shelf is very, very narrow. That is the reason the deepest port of the country is nothing but Vizag port. Vizag port is the deepest port in the country. So that's a very, 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 very important. Very, very important. So like this, do remember this port. And on seaports, major seaports, the questions are asked in the examinations. So here if you see, the answer is nothing but Vishakhapatnam port. So Kandla is present in Gujarat, Chennai is present in Tamil Nadu, Mumbai is present in Maharashtra, New Delhi, obviously there is no port at all. Okay, so that is not an option. Who was the first Indian to receive a Nobel Prize? See your question. First Indian to receive Nobel Prize. Option A, Mother Teresa. Option B, Hari Gobind Khurana. Option C, C.V. Raman, Sir C.V. Raman. Option D, Rabindranath Tagore. Option none of these. If you see out of all these things, they are asking first Indian. Means what? The person should be an Indian citizen. If you take, obviously, these three people names we have to be discussing. Out of this, if you see, the first Nobel Prize was received by Rabindranath Tagore in the year 1913. After this, in the year 1928, Sir C.V. Raman got this Nobel Prize. And then we got Mother Teresa. Mother Teresa got in 1978, if I'm not wrong. Okay. So like this, these are the three Indian citizens who have received a Nobel Prize. So the obvious the answer is nothing but Rabindranath Tagore for the novel called as a Geetanjali. For Geetanjali, he has received a Nobel Prize for a peace. That's for literature. For literature, Rabindranath Tagore got. For science, he got. For peace, Mother Teresa received the Nobel Prize. The first railway line was laid in, remember that, in the world, the first railway line started between North and East England. So, northern part and eastern part of England only, they started the first railway line in the country. So, obviously, the answer is nothing but D. Answer is nothing but D. Which of the following countries has the briefest constitution in the world? So, we know that the lengthiest constitution, written constitution in the world is nothing but India. But you come to the briefest constitution. Option A, Russia. Option B, UK. Option C, USA. Option D, France. Option D, Germany. The right answer is nothing but USA. USA has got the briefest constitution in the world. Okay. Answer is C, USA. What is the name of the first test tube baby of the world? So, it took place somewhere in 2006, I guess. And option A, Leslie O'Connor. Option B, Priscilla Schaffer. Option C, Lose Joy Brown. Option D, Patricia Spare, and option E, none of this. The answer is number Lose Joy Brown. So, first test tube baby. So, you know that there is a process called IVF, intravertilization fertility process. So, using this IVF process, they will try to take the semen and egg and they will try to do the process of reproduction process in a test tube. So, that's called as a test tube baby. So, Lose Joy Brown is the first test tube baby in the world. World's largest temple corridor is located in, very, very famous. Option A, Srirangapatnam. Option B, Rameshwaram. Option C, Kanchipuram. Option D, Madurai. None of this. The answer is Rameshwaram. You go to Rameshwaram, there is a Shiva temple and that has got the longest corridor present in the world. So, the answer is nothing but obviously option B, Rameshwaram. The first satellite was launched by, who launched the first satellite? Option A, Japan. Option B, USA. Option C, USSR, France, and then India. You see that when you come to cosmonauts, USSR is top. But when you come to these satellites, immediately when NASA was established, in few days, they have put a satellite into space. So, the answer is obviously USA, United States of America. Okay. And NASA has put this satellite in the space. So, answer is nothing but USA. Where was the selection of the suitable candidates for particular jobs first started through a competitive examinations? You know that nowadays Everywhere earlier, you know, you apply in the employment board, you'd be called if your list name comes. But now people are selecting on the merit basis. So they're conducting examinations. Now, for the first time, in which country did they start recruiting for jobs using the competitive examinations? And remember that it is none other than China which has started this process. So it is China in the world is the first country to start a national level examinations for recruiting aspirants for desired jobs. So the answer is nothing but China. Yes, world's longest snake reticulated python is found in India. So this is one of the world's longest one, and they found this in the Nicobar. In Nicobar Islands, this has been found. So, very, very big python has been found. It is one of the very poisonous also. It is one of the very, very poisonous python. And it is found in the Nicobar. So, that's all for today. Thank you. See you all again. Bye-bye.